Hi, flat white, please.
That'll be $5. No, $5 American.
What? This is New Zealand.
Sadly, Connor's mistake wasn't about paying $5 American instead of $5 Kiwi. No, his mistake cost him hundreds.
I was in a rush. I was on a broken down bus in Dunedin trying to get a same day flight up to Christchurch.
But when he arrived at check-in, Connor realised he'd booked on the wrong website and had booked in American dollars. And what's worse,
they said, oh, you booked for tomorrow.
He called the reservations team only to be told to go through international bookings.
I ended up paying hundreds of dollars to get it changed to the correct flight in New Zealand dollars.
The same thing happened to Cherie, who's in Lincoln, just out of Christchurch. Cherie and her friends were travelling to Wellington for World of Wearable Art. They decided on an affordable hotel, so she searched on her phone, found what she thought was the hotel's website, and put in her dates.
And I got back a little box in the middle of the screen that told me that there wasn't anything available, but if I rang the number on the screen, I could get, they would check their availability.
Cherie was quoted around $1,400 for three rooms, but she didn't realise that that was in, you guessed it, American dollars. So instead of each room costing $477, she was charged $786. Ouch.
I was in New Zealand, I was booking a New Zealand hotel, I was ringing an Auckland number. I had gone as far as asking them, is this a call centre? I didn't think I needed to go as far as, where are you at call centre?
And you've been in touch with different companies to find out who you actually booked with. Any luck with that?
I've sent emails to every email address I can find or locate or been given, and I've so far not been able to cancel.
It seems like this is an easy trap to fall into, even if you think you've done everything right. So the question remains,
so what can I do to make sure I don't make a mistake like that?
If you're on a website where there's no currency specified, check out the Contact Us page for clues as to where the company's based. If you're not sure, message or email the site to confirm cost and currency before putting it on the card. If you're booking a New Zealand hotel or flight, check the web address to make sure you're contacting them directly. Direct booking customers may be offered extra discounts or incentives. And just some final advice to help you hold on to these precious dollars.
I should have listened to my husband when he told me, don't do that on your phone. You need to be in front of a laptop so you're 100% certain of the website address that you are dealing with.
I've absolutely learned my lesson to just slow down and actually be familiar with the correct website and just take a second look. There's no need to rush.